This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, everyone. I am Rajni Jain. On behalf of agricultureinformation.com, I like to welcome you all to this online meeting. The duration of online meeting is normally for about 30 to 40 minutes. We request all the participants to mute themselves to avoid background disturbances. I now request the moderator, Mr. Lakshmipathy, to introduce the speaker and start the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Rajini. Good morning, everyone. I am Lakshmipathy. I'll be moderating this meeting. Agricultureinformation.com likes to welcome Mr. Rajendra Kumar to this meeting. Mr. Rajendra Kumar is the Business Development Manager for South and East Asia region, Crevo Equipment Limited, Canada. I will be speaking on the topic, Automatic Retractable Roof Greenhouse Technology for Tropical Climate. The speaker will talk briefly about the topic. Then the participants will be able to ask questions. Questions can also be added to the chat window. Please note, this is an agriculture-related meeting where speakers and participants are likely to come from even rural and remote areas. Internet connections are likely to be disrupted. If there are any internet disturbances during the meeting and the speaker gets disconnected, I request the participants to bear with us and remain patient. We will try to reconnect with the speaker again. If there are repeated disconnections, then as a last resort, we may need even to cancel the meeting and reschedule to an alternative date. I now request the speaker to begin.
Thank you, Lakshmipathy ji. And
you're welcome.
Thank the agricultureinformation.com for with your organization. I am associated for the last four or five years. I'm a regular visitor to your website. And good morning, everyone. My name is Rajendra. As Lakshmipathy has told that I am working as a business development manager for South and East Asia for a Canadian company called Crevo. I did my graduation from YS Parmar University of Horticulture and Forestry, Solan, and did my master's in agriculture economics from GB Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar. And I joined this company in 2014. Crevo is a world leader in retractable roof production technology. So you might have heard the word the greenhouse or protected cultivation. This is a one part of protected cultivation technology, which is normally used in the tropical and mild climate. So I will go with a brief video, which will give you the outline that how this technology works in the tropical and mild climate.
Thank you.
Mr. Mr. Rajendra Kumar, you can hear me?
Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay, okay. Because we are not able to hear you. Maybe the silence from the other end.
I'm playing the video. I don't know whether you are able to see or not.
Okay, okay, right. I understand. We understand. Yes, sir. You are looking for the slide. Okay, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you looking for a specific slide, Mr. Rajendra Kumar?
Okay, okay. So you want me to start again?
No, we have not heard anything. We didn't hear anything.
No voice. No audio.
The past 5 minutes, we thought you are looking for a particular slide.
No, actually, I'm playing it. I do not know whether you are able to see or not. Okay.
Now we are able to hear you. Now we are able to hear you.
Okay, so should I share again or should I continue with my presentation?
You know, you are talking about your company, Crevo. You are talking about the structural, construction company. Yes, please continue from there.
Mr. Lakshmipathy, the video hasn't, the audio part of this video hasn't.
Audio is not working.
Yeah, so that hasn't worked, but the video continued. We could see it, but we can't hear anything.
Okay, okay.
Mr. Rajendra Kumar, as you are showing the video, you can explain on it.
Okay, no issue. I will explain it. I think most of you might have seen this video. Let me explain this way. You might have seen the greenhouse structure with a covered roof, with a permanent covered roof. You have a roller ball on the side. But in Crevo system, our roof is not a completely covered. It is actually retractable. In this video, it shows that when you have a ideal condition, just like during summer or be in the morning, in the evening, or during winter, we have a very good condition during daytime or in the morning time or in the evening time. So roof will remain retracted. It will close only when you have a adverse weather conditions. Just like that, you have a temperature 35 plus during summer, during daytime, and you have less than 10 during nighttime, or you have a rainfall, or you have a high wind speed. Only during the adverse conditions, your roof will close. Otherwise, it will remain open. So this is the meaning of this retractable roof. Means keep roof open when conditions are ideal for growing crop. Close only when you have a adverse condition. So it is nature plus protection. So in this actually this all system is connected to the weather system, and it's all automated structure. So we have actually four type of retractable roof structures. So like we have a retractable roof greenhouse, we have a retractable roof cooling house, then we have a retractable roof field covers and orchard covers. So depending on that where we are using, which crops we are covering, so we can classify into different system. So when we say retractable roof greenhouse, means basically the term greenhouse means to heat up the environment. But in our tropical system, we need a cooling system. But in northern climate, just like in Delhi or in North India, we have a severe winter also. And that's why in this area, we use the retractable roof greenhouse. So here, we have the clear roof on the top. And roof will, because during winter months, what happens that we have a low temperature during sometime daytime also or nighttime very low. So we close the roof during evening time so that we can trap the heat, and that trapped heat could be maintained throughout the night time. So this is, we call it a retractable roof greenhouse, and it's a particular that we use in the northern climate. Normally it is installed in 30 to 50 north-south latitude or at a higher elevation also. Then most of us, because in India that we have a more tropical type climate, so we need more retractable roof cooling house. So here we use the white cooling roof as a covering for hot climate. It is just like you can say that when we standing in outside in a sunny day, we put up a umbrella overhead. So what we are doing there, we are blocking the sunlight, mainly the infrared radiation, so that once we put up the umbrella, we feel the cool under the umbrella, but air temperature doesn't change. So similarly here also, we have a cooling roof. This roof also retract open and close as per outside weather condition. So when we close the roof, normally we think that it will heat up the environment, but it's not like, it's just like a umbrella type effect. It will cool the environment because we do not close the roof fully. It is a 95% close. 5%, there is always the reopening. So that 5% is sufficient to have an exchange of heat and humidity build up inside the house with the outside environment. So this type of cooling house we recommend for 0 to 30 degree north-south latitude. So in certain conditions, we had a both type of roof that we use. It's a greenhouse roof also or a cooling house roof also. Just like in Delhi, that we have a summer temperature very high and winter very, very low. So during summer, we need a cooling roof, and during winter, we need a heating type roof. So you can see that here on the left-hand side of this photograph, there are two roofs. Upper roof is clear roof, which we call a greenhouse roof, which is are normally used for the winter operation. And lower roof is a white one, which is a cooling roof, which is used for the summer operation. So all this operation is automatic actually, based on the daily weather condition. So you can see here in this picture on the left side, the inside view, and on the right side, you can see the outside view of the roof. So normally people think that when you open the roof, then you will invite the insects. But we have an option for that also. We can put up a stationary insect net below the roof or retractable insect net below the roof. It depends upon where you are putting your structure. Because normally in the dry conditions, we put up a stationary roof so that it will serve two purposes. One, to protect against the insect, and second, to maintain the humidity also. On the right hand side, you have seen the, this retractable insect net. So you can, just like a roof, you can open and close it as to maintain your humidity also. When you have insect pressure higher, so you can close it. When you have a higher humidity, you open it. So this is the flexibility in this type of system that we have. So you here you can see the we call this as a field cover actually. So any type of plant that you have, any shape, whether it's a rectangle or it's a round shape or it's whatever the shape of land, because normally you might have seen that if you build a paperly house or greenhouse, you need a rectangle shape. But in our case, we can cover the any piece of land. It may be any size. It may be 1 hectare. It may be 100 hectare. So with the same system, we can cover the whole area. So here in the picture, you can see that it's a large area that is covered under the this roof. This you can see that it's a very large area, 17 hectare. It's covered under the roof. And you can see that the shape is not rectangle. On the right hand side, you can see this, there are a lot of jogs there. So we try to cover the land, that maximum utilization of the land, so that your land, the value of land should not be wasted. So in India also, we have very large projects, just like 15 acres of single structure. And now we are building one of the largest structure in Asia. You can see 115 acre single structure in North India for growing blueberries or some other crops. So now you can see this is another field cover. This is the 11 hectare single structure in UK for growing the strawberry. You can see on the right side. So the shape of land is very different, but we have covered it like this. Left hand side, you can see the crop inside this retractable roof. So even if you have a normally a greenhouse or poly house, they are built up on a flat land. But in Crabo system, there is a flexibility. If you have a slope up to 4%, we can have an undulating type structure. We can build up like this as per the shape of land, so that your topsoil should not be disturbed. So here you can see the left side of the bigger picture. This is the project we did in Australia for growing cherries. So the land is undulating, but the slope is nearly 4%, up to 4%. So we have built up the structure as per the shape of land. So we have actually basically four type of design that we implement for retractable roof production technology. As you see, the flat roof is a structure that we normally build for tropical dry conditions where rainfall is very less, just like you can say the Rajasthan, or you can say the Kutch area in India. In Maharashtra, you can say the this Aurangabad area where rainfall is less than 500 mm. So flat roof is a very good structure for that area. You need not to have a gutter because gutter increased a lot of cost in the this greenhouse structure. So flat roof structure works very good in tropical dry locations. You can cover any shape of land as you have already seen those picture earlier. Did all these actually X-frame, A-frame and rafter house, they are for a actually high rainfall area. And, or you can say that's for a tropical humid type of climate. depending upon the intensity of rainfall. So X-frame is just like flat roof. X-frame is also for a large field cover. You can cover any field, any shape, size. But there is some limitation in the rafter and A-frame house. We can build large structure also, but rafter is normally used for nursery growing purpose, or you want to install something like the boom irrigation inside, so you need a wider span inside. Then we put up this rafter house. A-frame is actually a very top model. You can say that this type of structure used for the coastal area, where you have a very high wind speed, just like 200 kilometer per hour. As Dr. Puri, he belonged to, he's my senior from Odisha, that Odisha has a lot of, eastern coast has a lot of cyclones, which has a wind speed of 180, 200 kilometer per hour. So you can build up this A-frame structure. It's a very rigid, very strong, and very robust type structure. So let me tell you that in the last 35 years, Crabo has built up a structure in Florida, in California, in Indonesia, in the Philippines, but we have never lost a single structure due to cyclones or high wind speed. So this is the technology that we are using. So now, let me tell you that where we are, which crops we are growing. You can grow any type of crop, but I'm specifying some of crops that we are using, so that berries, a lot of people are now growing berries under the crabo. It may be blueberry, it may be strawberry, raspberry, because berries during the last 10 years, it has become a very popular, very, very valuable fruit, very high value fruit, you can say. And in India, if we see that we have a strawberry production in Mahabaleshwar and some other part in northern India, but it's very limited to 2 or 3 months, mainly for December, January, February. And rest of period, we have to actually either use the frozen or we have to import from outside. But with this type of system, we can extend our growing of these berries up to 7-8 months. Not, I can't say that it will be for a whole year, but we can extend for 7-8 months instead of 3 months. So as you see the top picture, that this is a blueberry that we are growing in UP. And we have found that from March onward till June 20th, we can get a regular crop during summer period. And the price is also very good during that period. Because if you know that blueberry is a superfood now, just like turmeric has become a superfood due to the COVID. So blueberry is also a superfood. So due to it's a nutritional value, and it gives the boost of our immunity also. So the demand for blueberries increasing very, very in the last few years, it has increased many folds. And if you see that normally the production of this crop is done in Northern America in colder type of climate, but there are some varieties which can be grown in a hotter climate area, but still we need some chilling hours to grow this crop. And if you see that in North America, the harvesting takes place from May onward till September, October. And in Southern Hemisphere, from Chile or some Australia or some other area, New Zealand, they harvest from November onward till January, February. So we have a very good price window between March till May, or you can say till 15th June, when we can harvest this crop in northern part of India and supply to the other countries. So here you can see the strawberry. Just like I told you, the blueberry, we can have strawberry, but still strawberry need a cooler night temperature actually. And you can find a suitable location at some higher elevation in Maharashtra or in southern India also. In northern India also we can grow it for extended period. This is the blueberry crop that I have mentioned to you, that on the left hand side you can see the crop, and right hand side you can see that how the harvesting done inside the structure, and packing is also done inside and sold directly to the market. So this is another crop, raspberry, which can be also tried here. And that's blackberry, it's also similar type of crop, it can be grown. And avocado, now at every retail shop you will find avocado in India also. Although it's a crop from Mexico, lot of the produce come to the India either from Mexico or Australia, but now it is becoming very popular here in India also. Many people are growing in South India. There are some projects in North India in the subtropical climate also. You can think this to grow this crop also under the protection for extended period. This leafy is leafy and herbs becoming very popular in the urban areas actually, but and especially for urban farming. So this is a project actually we have done with the Dabur just in Delhi, just near to the international airport. You can see that they are growing all kind of leafy and herbs year round. So as I told you earlier, that we have a double roof type structure which have a cooling roof for summer purpose and heating roof for winter purpose. So without any fan bed system, if you install this type of structure, you can save a lot of cost in because fan and bed system consume a lot of water and energy. So operational point of view, they are very costly. So here you can see the tomato. You can grow the tomato year round. So we are targeting basically the summer and rainy season when price window is very high, because normally in a tropical climate, you have a difficult to grow this crop during a rainy season when there is a gap in the demand and supply, and the prices are also very high. So you can see that with this type of system, you can grow this crop year round. So we have already made a lot of trials here, that if you sow a crop in the month of February, you can keep on harvesting till October, November. So it, you can say 8-9 month crop you can have under the Cravo system. Sweet pepper also, either it's a green or red. We have a company called Triangle Farm in Telangana. They are putting up a 15 acre structure in Jahirabad to grow this sweet pepper. So flowers can also be tried. We have a lot of project in USA, in Europe. So all kind of flower you can grow. Cannabis also become very popular during last 10, 15 years, especially in Canada and USA, and many European countries, they are now using it for medicinal purpose. So we have a lot of project for growing cannabis in USA and Canada, and many more are coming up in Africa, South Africa mainly. So they want to grow this cannabis under the Cravo system in a natural way. Apple also now because many although it's a temperate crop, it's not suitable for tropical, but I'm showing to you apple. Normally that apple grown in our country or anywhere in the world, they use 14 or 15 spray in a season to protect the crop. Mainly the lot of fungal issues and lot of bacterial issues that come that this crop face. So if you have this type of system, it not only help reducing your this fungicidal spray, but also the your quality of the fruit is very good. A reason behind that why the fungal spray is less in this type of system, because we have a protection against the rain or rain system here, and we keep our plants dry, because most of fungal issues they take place during due to the high humidity. So if you keep your plants dry, you can save the fungal problems. And normally in poly house, that because we have a covered roof, especially that people who belong to the Western Ghat area, just like Mumbai, Pune and other area, during this rainy season, you can't protect your crop in the poly houses, because you have a high temperature and very high humidity inside. So with this type of problem, you can get rid of in a crevice system. Because why I'm saying that you can save the fungal space, one that that you keep your plant dry. And another thing, that once the rain stops, you open your roof. Mm-hmm. If there is sunlight hit directly on the plant, and you can keep your plant dry. So that's the flexibility that you have under the detectable roof. So this fig is also another valuable crop, which you can grow very well, in good quality under the protection. Mm. Although that I have seen that in Nasik area in Maharashtra, people are growing in the open also. But if you want to have a good quality, you need some sort of protection. And cherry is another for the temperate area, not for the tropical area. Here I come to the nutraceutical crops actually. This like the, it's become very popular due to the term, this COVID issue, mainly the this turmeric and
somebody sorry to interrupt, Mr. Ravindra Saste, can you please unmute yourself? Mr. Ravindra, can you please unmute your mic? When the speaker finishes his talk, then we'll go for the question round. Thank you. Yes, Mr. Rajendra Kumar, we can proceed.
Thank you. So you can also try to grow turmeric and this ginger under the retractable roof. We have a project now going in Hyderabad, the company called Simply Fresh. So they have put up a 6-hectare project for growing turmeric only organically without using any chemicals. So another that you have nursery, you can grow all kind of nursery plants under the Trevo system. This is another use that you can put up this type of system for animal, any kind of animals. It may be your cows, it may be horse, it may be dogs, it may be pigs also. We are doing a project on pigs and poultry in Philippines now. So you can try this type of system also for animals to have a congenial environment for them. Just like we need a AC room, so your animals also need a congenial environment. for good milking and good growth. So you can use another, this is another use that for amusement purpose. Retractable roof is already used in this Disneyland in USA. You can put up in a retail garden center, you can put up over the swimming pool. So any use that, even there are some golf courses, you need a to have a party or something like that. So you can put up this system for having a good environment for your customer. So in India, we started our operation 2015. So we did first project with Namdhari in Karnataka. They put up a 1 hectare structure with us for the research purpose. In the single structure, we have a 3 growing zone. So all 3 growing zone, if you see the picture on the right hand side, so we have a 3 portions there. So you can operate these operations, these roofs separately in all 3 growing zones. This is the crop. Basically, they are actually trying the, they are maintaining their germplasm, seed germplasm, because they are the seed company. So they have to, after few period, they have to actually maintain their germplasm, the parental lines of the vegetables. So they maintain in this structure here. This is a project we have in Pattaya in Thailand. So it is just near to the sea. So they wanted to grow leafy and herbs year round for the local hotel industry. So this project we have put up in 2016. So very typical climate, very hot and humid almost throughout the year, no winter there. So you can see the crop here on the right hand side, and this is the client that on the left hand side. And this is the Dower project, you can see we did in Delhi, just near to the international airport. I have already explained it. KBC is actually subsidiary of the Dower. So they are going for expansion now. This is the same Dower project from outside and inside. This is the berries project that we did in Vrindavan. You can see the on the right hand side, the covered roof and open roof. So in fruit crop, we put up a bird net below the roof so that birds should not destroy your crop. Here you can see the berries inside, and you can see the person that who has harvested the berry, fresh berry. And this is the nursery project we did in Indonesia, the company called Aprilisia. It is one of the largest forestry plantation company in the world. So this area, actually Indonesia, there are thousands of islands there, and they have a very peculiar climate. So it is a hot and humid throughout the year, almost same. So when they grow nursery, it becomes a very plant is not strong. It's called a lanky type of plant. So they are replacing every year the existing structure they have purchased from China or Korea with the Crabo system, because here they are getting a very hardy plant, so they can transport their plants from this location to many islands in Indonesia or maybe in Africa or other countries. So this is, you can see the this is the nursery there on the right hand side. This is a project we did in Qatar actually in 2019. This become operational in the month of June. So here also it's a very unique climate, just like the Kutch area, the similar type of climate here in Qatar also. Daytime very hot, and but in Qatar the nighttime temperature is also very high. It's more than 32 degrees during night also. That causes a problem for flowering and fruit setting. So with some corrections, so they are growing now the vegetable, different kind of vegetable, as you can see here. On the left hand side, here we have put up two type of models there, flat roof and X-frame. Right hand side, you can see the cucumber and some zucchini on the upper side. So they are growing multiple crops now. This year, now they are going for expansion, big expansion. So this is the one of the largest project we are doing in India. You might have heard the Simply Fresh. So Sachin, he is a very, very innovative, very progressive guy. So he had a earlier 5 acre of structure, which he has purchased from China. There was some issues with them. So now this 30-acre project is coming up with the Crabhook. There are different type of models there. There is X-frame there. There is A-frame there. And so for the different uses. So they are growing leafy. They are growing tomato, capsicum, cucumber, the berries also. They are growing nutraceutical crops. So it's actually they are growing many type of crop, not only for the domestic market, but also they are targeting for the export market for the high value customer. So this is another project that Triangle Farm we are doing in Jahirabad. They are doing very well now. They have a nut houses. They have a gravel system. This system will be functional probably in the month of November, but they are building one of the largest X-frame structures spreading over the 6 hectare area. So many more are coming up now. As I told up that we are now going for 115 acre in North India for blueberry plantation. So similar more projects are coming up. So thanks, sir.
Thank you.
So if you have
thank
any
you, Mr.
Question,
Rajendra Kumar. Yes, yes. Thank you, Mr. Rajendra Kumar, for an excellent presentation. Now we will go to the question round, and I request the participants to ask their questions. We'll also be posting the speaker's contact details in the chat window, so that if you don't have time to take up all the questions, you can contact the speaker separately after the meeting. Now we'll move on to the participants for asking their questions. And meanwhile, Mr. Rajendra Kumar, can you kindly remove the screen?
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Yes, question, Mr. Girish Puri. Yes, yeah. Professor Krishna.
Good morning.
Yes, please, sir.
Yeah, very, very informative and nice presentation, Mr. Kumar. You see, now my question is about that. You said four types of structures, a sectable structure you have to see, categorize that. And what is the cost analysis that per hectare, that cost analysis of that?
Thanks, Dr. Grace.
Are you
Yeah. Thank you very much. And you are my super senior.
So, yeah. Thank you.
Thanks for your good question. We have the four different models actually. So price varies. Different models have a different price, and there are a lot of applications also, because when we work out the specifications, so because we normally try to customize any project, so my price may vary from $20 to $150 depending upon your climate, what crops you want to grow there, and how much area you want to cover. So at present, to for me to say that what will be the price per acre, so it is very difficult for me to say, because we have to work out that as per your climate.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Right. Thank you.
Thank you.
I can give you the range of models, different models. That if you give me your email ID, or you put up a question in my email box, then I can send you the price range of different model.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question, participants.
Hello.
Yes, with Mr. Yes, Mr. Hemant. Yes, Mr. Hemant.
Yeah, to ask, what is the website where we can see the presentation again or see the actual happening on the retractable roof? Because what we are observing is that our poly houses, they get torn and damaged due to storm and rains and summer. So I wanted to see the website.
That's a very good question, Hemantji. That because once you have a crop and you have put up capital cost also to build up a your project, it may be 1 acre, it may be 10 acre, but when you grow the you have the crop inside also, and if all of a sudden the storm comes, it everything is gone. So that is happening most part of at most of places because of what I can say that we need to select the appropriate technology for a appropriate climatic condition. In our if you want to go through all the details, you can go to our website www.cravo.com. So you can also actually talk to me separately. I can share you some of the videos that we have taken during storm period, that how when there is a storm of 140 kilometer that we have faced in Vrindavan in North India, and nothing happened to our structure there, although that lot of other buildings that in the surrounding area or some other structure, they gone, they were torn off, but not the Cravo system structure were totally unaffected. So I can share you some of the videos, some of the detail, technical detail, that how we designed this type of system. So kindly send me your request on my email. You can also send my on WhatsApp also. My same number 98160805800. You can send the WhatsApp message on this number.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you. Next question. Mr. Rajendra Kumar, can you please remove the screen so that we'll have better control over the participants? Can you stop sharing the screen?
Okay. Let me see that where.
Okay, participants. Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Dr. Gururaj Achar, to ask the next question.
Yeah. Good morning, Rajendra. It's a very interesting presentation. Well,
good morning, sir.
Towers where there is, as well as what you said about protected farming, where the agricultural industry is facing a lot of recession, lot of economic issues. You think this is a viable project for us?
Sir, for a small size, actually, I don't think that if you are planning less than 5 acre or something like that, if you are in a rural area, so I don't think it is a viable. But if you put up a large area, 10 acre, 20 acre, 15 acre, something like that, then the viability is there. But for a smaller size, viability is not, because this we have this automation system here. We have a climate control system here. So that cost is same for a 10 hectare structure or 1 hectare structure, the same cost. So we actually, for research purpose or for a pilot purpose, that you can put up a small area, but that's not a viable. You can have some you can train your people or something like that, but ultimately you have to go for a larger area.
The cost is prohibitively high.
Cost for smaller structure is very high.
Can it be done over a rooftop now?
We have done such project also, but rooftop normally because area is very small on the roof. But if you have a larger area, then there is a viability. But smaller area is difficult. Viability is a issue with the rooftop.
Thank you very much, Rajendra. Nice listening to you.
Welcome, sir.
Welcome. Thank you. And any more for next question? Can I invite next question from the participants? Mr. Keshav.
Yes, yeah, Mr. Keshav. Yeah, so are there any projects we have done near Bangalore or Mysore, this area in South India?
As I told that we have done the project with the Namdhari, but that project is not in the Mysore side. That is on the Tumkur side, actually. If you go to the Tumkur side, then you can see this Kravo project here. It is almost for 5 years now.
Okay. And the one, the showed one Simply Fresh. Where is that done?
It is a place called Arjun Patala in Telangana. It's around 80 to 100 kilometers from Hyderabad. Toward the eastern side. Yeah. Place is Arjun Patla.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Mr. Uday Kumar, to ask the next question.
Yeah. Good morning, Rajan, sir. This is Uday Kumar from Bangalore. When we compare to other poly house, they have a subsidy from the government. Do we get the subsidy for the similar kind for your structures?
Actually, some people, they tried, they have approached the National Horticulture Board that can we get the subsidy on Crabo type of structure. So they said that we can give the subsidy, but the upper limit will be the same as for the poly house. Over and above, the client has to make the investment for that.
Compared to other general products, what is available in the market? When we compare the price, what is the percentage we have to pay extra for your structure? No doubt about your quality and rigidness, what you have demonstrated in a video. What will be the price difference, sir?
It depends. Actually, as I told earlier also, that it's very very tricky for us also to say the price, because our price varies from $20 to $150. So it depends upon your climate, actually, mainly the microclimate, what type of climate you have there, and how much your area you wanted to cover, and what crops you are planning to grow. So the price of our models vary, actually. So that's the very because we try to customize the model as per your climate. It is not like a poly house, that similar structure, same structure you will find in Pune, same you will find here in Punjab, same you will find in, if you go to Himachal, in the cold area, you will have the same structure, same design, same specification. But this is not like here with the Crabo.
Okay.
So what is required for your crop and climate? So we put up only that thing.
Can we integrate the solar system to run the whole system for 1 acre? Or we want to draw the 3-phase power from the, because in the rural area, power is the biggest problem.
That can be done, but you have to see that how to strengthen the structure on the roof, actually. Because you have to, if you're planning to have a solar system on the roof. We have done one project in Florida, actually, in USA, almost 10 years back. So they have put up some solar panels on the roof. So it is still working there. So, but I have to take more details for that.
Okay.
Thank you. Mr. Alok Dotekar, you have got any question? Mr. Ajay Dior?
Sir, I wanted to ask, but he has asked for specific area, etc., to understand the ballpark figure for the costing that is required for this project. So anything at least as a ballpark figure, say 5 acres, how much would it be, and otherwise minimum what should be the area?
Okay, it's a good question actually. Yeah, it's a good question. Let me say in this way, we have a 4 design actually, that 4 model that we normally implement in any climate condition. The flat roof model, which is normally for a tropical dry location, and there are certain crops which can withstand the rain also. So flat roof price for 1 hectare is $20. So you can say $20 to $25 price for a 1 hectare model. But this price is, I'm saying the CIF price, not the installed price. So after that, you have to bear the custom duty, you have to bear the installation cost or the local transportation also. But our price will be in between $20 to $25 per hectare, not per acre, per hectare. Similarly, for if you go for a X-frame type model for 1 hectare, the price will be roughly between $40 to $50 per square meter. It depend upon that the specifications also, that if you have a one roof, you have a double roof or insect net or roll up wall. So all these add up the cost actually. So we work the cost as per the need of your climate. So then we have the rafter actually. If you have a wind speed of 140 or 170, then rafter is the good model for that area. And or you wanted to put up some nursery, large scale nursery, then rafter design is very good because it has a wider span, 4.63 meter wider span. So that the price of that is almost $10-$15 higher than this X-frame model. Maybe it may be $50 or $60 per square meter. A-frame is the top model actually. So you can price for A-frame for 1 hectare will be something like $70 per square meter. But in this A-frame, we can give you the smaller size also. Even for rafter also, we can build the smallest size of 1,000 square meter minimum size. But the cost will be very high for those smaller structures because the automation and control system that is used for 1 hectare, the price cost will be same for 1,000 square meter. So that's the reason that price per square meter will go very high.
Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Ravindranath, you have a question? Mr. Rahul Ramchandra? Mr. Venkatesha? Mr. Siddhappa?
No, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Ravi Karpaya? Mr. Chandra? Mr. Keshav has got a question again. Yes, please, Keshav.
Sir, like you are giving the estimate in dollars. So, like, is there any, I don't know whether it's the like completion, for the completion of the project you are giving that, or is there any additional cost involved? Like when we need to set up it in India?
Yeah, definitely. Because our this manufacturing facility is in Canada actually. So this whole system is imported from there. Until unless you are building up a large project, just like we are building this 115 acre. So we can think of sourcing the local material also. But in other small projects, we have to import the system from Canada. Then you have to bear the cost of import duty, the local transportation means from seaport to the your location, then installation cost involved there, so that you have to bear.
So this is Canadian dollar, like when you're talking.
No, it's US dollar. US dollar.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sudhir Ranjan Mandal. You have a question. Mr. Shivalaya. Okay. Mr. Rajendra Kumar, I want to read out a few questions from the chat window. First question is from Mr. Ravindra Saste. What is the HS2 and the benefit of using it?
HS2 is actually trade name of the roof plastic, that polyethylene that we use. It's a cross laminated woven polyethylene, which has a life of 8 to 12 years. Sometimes it lasts for 15 years also. Normally that you might have seen in a poly house or in a here in India, that when we use the polyfilm, that lasts for 3, 4, or 5 years. But our this polyethylene, this plastic lasts for up to 15 years also. So that has a very long life.
Right. Is Mr. Ravindra Sastre again with another question. How much minimum area can we do in retractable greenhouse, and whether the project will be viable?
There are two different issues. Minimum size, we can do 1,000 square meter, but the viability depend upon the location and the crop. So 1,000 square meter is good for research purpose, for nursery purpose, for these things. But it depend upon that, which crop you are doing, what is your location. So viability depend upon that. Ravindra Sastre is himself consultant, so I know him. You know that economist.
Yes. Yes, yes. Okay. Next question is from Mr. VG. What is the material being used?
Means that we use the American standard, the pipe material, that the structural material, that's the good quality one. Polyethylene, I have already told that it's also has a very long life. It's a woven polyethylene, and whatever the material we use, we are a company based in Canada, so we have only one manufacturing base there. So we ship the structure from there to Australia, New Zealand, Chile, so many countries actually, all over the world. So we try to build up a very robust structure with a robust design. So we do a lot of homework that, so that this client should not ask us for anything thereafter. If you see that we have sold the first project here in India in 2015. So in the last 5 years, they have not asked anything from us except for the upgradation of their software. So we have done this project in Philippines. It is almost 7-8 years old. I didn't know that they have even called me in the last 7-8 years. So that's the actually, because if I'm not saying that there is no issue in our system. There may be problems, but we have a very good communication system. We have a, first of all, that on the website itself, we have a maintenance section. We have, if you have any problem with the drive or roof or cable or something like that, so we'll find the video how to repair that. And if you have any major problem, so you can call me on my WhatsApp number. So we have already a greenhouse engineer here in India who look after all these. The technical issues.
Thank you. Dr. Gururaj Achar has got another question to ask.
Okay, sir.
Mr. Rajendra, I would like to ask
you, sir.
What will be the add-on price percentage over a product coming out of the automatic roof in comparison with the open forming product? What will be the price? Like, should I have to say, if a tomato is costing 30 rupees a kilo, should I have to order? What will be the price percentage because of the add-on feature?
Guru Rajesh sir, you have a very good question actually. So let me say this way, that when open field is in production, there is no use of Cryvo. When open field stop the production, Cryvo has the value. Have you got my answer, or should I explain more? Let me say in this way, because most of open field production takes place in India during winter months in the plain area. And from March, April onward till August, September, because then we have a summer season, which is very hot. Then we have a rainy season, which is very rainy. So during these 4-5 months, we have a very problem with the production of the crops in the open field. So you need a protection. So normally that whenever we plan a project with the CREVO system, so we plan in such a way so that we are in production during off season when the open field is not in production. Let me give you one example. Let's take the case of tomato. Normally that tomato is grown in the winter, or there is some production in the summer also, but it is in the slopy land on the higher elevation. But if you see the month of June, July, August, September, even till October, the price of tomato is very high in the market because there is a gap between the demand and supply. And there is also your supply is coming from a very far distance, like that during this day, Delhi is getting tomato from Solan in Himachal Pradesh. That is almost 600 kilometers from Delhi. So there is also the transportation cost, transportation losses. So once you harvest today, then it will reach to the customer after 3 days, then quality will deteriorate. So there are a lot of issues with that. So you can plant the CREVO system in the Delhi itself to grow the tomato year round. But you have to target the off season when open field in the Delhi surrounding area is not in production. In the or you have to target some specialty type of tomato, just like cherry tomato or beef tomato, or now the many type of snacking tomato are coming up. So you have to make something different from your open field farming. So then it is viable. Otherwise, it's not a viable.
Thank you. Mr. Thank Joseph you. Brito has just joined. Mr. Joseph Brito, you have any question to ask? Okay, no questions. Okay, I presume there are no more questions to ask. Thank you for answering all those questions, Mr. Rajendra Kumar. We have now completed the round of questions. Yes, Mr. Gary Kirishpuri, you have a question to ask?
No, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Now we have completed the round of questions. I'd like to thank Mr. Rajendra Kumar on behalf of Agriculture Information for taking his time to speak with us with an excellent presentation and answers. I now request the organizer of the meeting, Ms. Rajini Jain, to please close the meeting. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mr. Gatiji. Thank you, Rajini. And thank you, Srimati, and another lady, because I am connected with you for the last 5-6 years. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, then. Wish you all the best.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lakshmipathy. I like to thank the speaker, Mr. Rajendra Kumar, for taking the time to talk with us. I also like to thank all the participants for their time. This meeting will be now closed. Thank you.